I know you guys just got through production on Mixed-ish before all of this shut down, but you didn't for Saved by the Bell. How much did you actually get through shooting? Because we're seeing the trailer today, which is amazing.
Yeah, I just saw the trailer as well. It's pretty amazing. We finished Mixed-ish on a Friday. On a Monday, I went to go prep for Saved by the Bell, which meant if you see my Instagram, I was putting the wig on and getting that fitted. We went through all the wardrobe process. We were talking, we did the camera tests. And so that was the week after Mixed-ish. Then the week after that, we were going to start our production. They had been in production since January, but because of my schedule and because of Tiffany Thiessen's schedule, we couldn't join the production when it started. And so we had about 2 weeks left of filming just Tiffany and my footage. But it's put on hold. So hopefully we're gonna get back to that and then go right back into Mixed-ish whenever we can. It's a whole different look too, because I have my hair tied back in a man bun.
Now it's interesting too, because I thought about the fact that you are the governor of California in this new Saved by the Bell. Does it give you pause thinking about what the real governor of California is doing, the decisions he's having to make, the work he's having to do right now?
My hat goes off to everyone who is making the tough decisions in this state and country and the world, really. The interesting thing was, in the original script, Zack Morris, as the governor, takes a phone call, and we only hear Zach's side of the phone call, but he was having a phone call about some sort of pandemic. And that was written before we even knew about this. That was written last year.
You know, you've done so much and so many different roles. I do wonder what it was like that moment you stepped back into Zack Morris. Like, what is that like to go back to that and step back into that mode? Is it just like an actor's like method, or did it do something for you? Because it was so iconic for you in your career.
Well, putting on the wig, thankfully, I didn't have to dye my hair this time, which I dyed for 6 years when I was on the original show. But putting on the wig and saying those lines again, it wasn't like jumping back into a character. So much time has passed. And so I was taking that week that we had before the lockdown to sort of get back into the character, to understand him. Because there is a way that he says things, and they can come off, if you say them in the wrong way, they can come off very douchey, and not very, they can come off in a negative spin. So the guy who plays, the actor who plays my son, Mitchell Hogue, I think he's brilliantly cast, and he does a really good job of towing that line of saying things that are offensive, but if you say them in the light of a Zack Morris way, it's effervescent, and it's you can't take offense to it.
Right.
And so I was using that week to understand that character again, and I was looking forward to it. I can't wait to play the character again. I was I'm looking forward to joining Mario and Elizabeth and the fun that they've had, and then Tiffany and I can't wait. There's some really good things that are gonna come out of this.
I can't wait. I'm so glad to hear you say you can't wait to play him again, because we can't wait to see it again. We really cannot.
The show looks great too. The way that it's shot. I mean, I hadn't seen anything. I haven't been on set. You know, everything for us has just been prep. But watching the trailer and seeing how it's shot, I think it's very smart. Tracy Wigfield and all the other writers are doing a great job with all the scripts. So it looks amazing, and the content's great.
Babe, you know we can't push back on this. We have to let her find her own way.
And what if she says she wants us to take her to a Debbie Gibson concert?
I think that we could call this finale of Mixed-ish, like, be careful what you ask for, you just might get it.
Yeah, I think throughout the entire first season, we were always trying to non-conform and trying to get back to some sort of semblance of what we came from, which was the commune, which was free, spirited, free loving, free everything, and not being tied down to society. And we get an opportunity to join Jesse Jackson's campaign. And this is the thing, I think, more so for Paul than Alicia. gives him purpose and is going to, he wants to make a change in the world. And Alicia is making a change in the world. And Paul doesn't realize this, but he is as well by staying home with his children. Mm-hmm. But this is a finale in which, will we stay in the house that we've built or that my father has provided us? Or will we go back on the road and campaign for Jesse Jackson's presidential campaign and make a difference in that way? And the thing that puts a cog in the wheel is Alicia gets a very big job offer to stay. And she has to make a decision of whether or not she's going to stay and whether or not she's going to stay with Paul. So it's a pretty big episode.
And I love too, I was telling Tika, I was waiting for that like full-throated crossover with Mixed-ish and Black-ish. And the way we got it was amazing. I was so excited. It was such a great episode. I loved it.
Yeah, it was fun to see everybody dressed up and in the future. And I kind of put the beard back on and had a different look. And we kind of know what Paul's going to look like. And then Alicia as well. So, you know, he takes sort of liberties, but it was still fun. It was fun to see Tracee Ellis Ross all dressed up and in her cap and gown and Anthony Anderson.
That's my baby.
He's the best. And I was sitting right next to him and all that stuff is ad-libbed. You know, it's just Anthony being Anthony and it's good stuff.